Well, good afternoon, everyone. It is a pleasure to welcome the preference to Washington, but I really should say back to Washington. I think you probably spent as much time here, including as a student at American University, as any of us have. So this is almost a second one. And so we're so pleased to welcome you here, to welcome you back. It is evidence of, we were just talking about this, an extraordinary, long-standing partnership between Bahrain and the United States, going back 75 years, through thick and thin. And we deeply appreciate it, deeply value it, and it's important not only to remind ourselves of that, but of course to focus on the work that we have before us going forward. I want to say at the outset how much we appreciate Bahrain's strong support for the resolution, the historic resolution voted today at the United Nations General Assembly, condemning the Russian aggression against Ukraine, supporting Ukraine in its efforts to preserve its sovereignty, its territorial integrity, its independence. This was a remarkable moment, 141 countries coming together loudly, clearly on this matter. We're grateful for Bahrain's support. Bahrain, of course, is a major non-NATO ally, close partner on security, but also on many other issues. I applaud as well the work for the Abraham Accords to relations between Bahrain and Israel, and of course other countries in Israel, to a place where the benefits to the people of both countries are strongly felt. And applaud your leadership on that as well. So we have a lot to talk about. There's a lot going on in the world, a lot going on in the region. And it's really good to have you here to be able to pursue our conversations. Welcome.
Mr. Secretary, ladies and gentlemen, it's a real pleasure to be here. Thank you for welcoming me. It is homecoming of sorts always when I come to Washington. It's a city I know well. It is a city that has had great impact on myself, people of Bahrain, and my country. Over the 75 years, we have built a security partnership that has guaranteed the security and stability, not just of the region, but of the world. And we have played a key role, small though we are, in ensuring that the United States and the responsible governments of the world can preserve an international rules-based order. This is key. We have decades now of general political needs, and that is largely due to that international rules-based order. Its current state of affairs is deeply concerning, and I think we must do everything in our power to urge everyone to de-escalate and to return to the more normative ways of solving issues. In any case, I'm very happy that we can come here on the back of that 75-year history, and on to bigger and better things. And I look forward to discussing ways that we can enhance our strategic security relationship and our strategic economic relationship. Also, by becoming ever more close in our work together, I think there is inevitably an exchange of values and shared vision. And that can't be bad for you. So thank you for welcoming us. Thank you for the
thanks, everyone.